just in case your professor wants you to know about it, just in case he wants to throw something, he or she wants to throw something crazy, let's just go ahead and do this one. All right? So what we've got here is a declin. And notice that I've drawn the H's in a specific way, so pay attention to that. And it says, please draw the declin as a chair conformation in the most stable conformation. Okay? So I know this is the first time you've done this, so I'm not going to like ask you guys to pause the video and then come back, because it's something that I don't expect you guys to be able to do very well. Let's just do it together, and then you guys will see how this works. Okay? So first of all, which declin should I be drawing? Should I be drawing cis or trans? I should be drawing trans declin. Why? Because I've been given a trans declin. Okay? But let's say that I had instead given you another declin that looked like this, and it just had sticks for H's. Okay? Then which way should I draw it? Should I draw it cis or should I draw it trans? And the answer is that I should still draw it trans. Why? Because remember that trans is going to be the most stable as possible. The most stable possible declin. So if it's asking me for the most stable conformation, then I'm going to draw trans no matter what. Okay? So now we've got that settled, let's go ahead and draw our trans declin. What that's going to look like, and this is one of the hardest parts about it, just being able to draw it. You draw your chair conformation like normal. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Okay? Then what you do is you draw another chair coming directly off of that one. Okay? So I'm going to draw another stick coming off like that. And then I'm just going to make the dip on the other side. So I'm going to do this, and this, and that. Okay? And that actually came out pretty nice. I don't always draw it that nice. Okay? It takes a little bit of practice. But there we go. We've got our trans declin. Let's go ahead and we can draw in the H's just so that they know what we're doing. And now all I have to do is I have to figure out where to put that terp butyl group. Okay? So first of all, how many carbons away is it from a bridgehead? 2, okay? The bridgehead is here, so what that means is that my terp butyl should be right here, okay? So now it's asking for the most stable conformation. Should I put it in the axial position or the equatorial position? Which one? Equatorial, okay? So I'm going to put this in the equatorial position, and we are done, okay? That is the answer to this question. That is the most stable conformation of this declin, okay? Now, there are different variations of this question. For example, your professor could give you two substituents. Then you have to figure out, okay, which one wants the equatorial preference, okay? But it would still be the same principle as we learned in chair conformations, that you just go with the larger group wanting the equatorial preference, okay? So I hope that that made sense. If your professor didn't talk too much about declins, then you can feel free to skip this or not practice it so much, okay? But I just put this in here just in case, all right? So let's go ahead and move on.